So if you think we can start, yes, this is the moment.
Yep.
So welcome everybody on this online talk. For those who don't know, I am Tomasz Raducha. I am a PhD student from University of Warsaw in Poland, now working at IFISC until at least September. Well, working at IFISC as soon as the lockdown ends, hopefully. And I will present our most recent work done together with Maxi under title of Emergence of Complex Structures from Nonlinear Interactions and Noise in Coevolving Networks. And this will be just a brief overview. So if you're interested in any details, you can ask me a question at the end or look at the publication. It's already on the IFISC webpage under the same title. And there is an archive link to the PDF, because we only recently submitted it to a journal. So what we try to do in this paper is we look what three effects, real-world network mechanisms include in one model simultaneously can produce, like structure-wise, and looking at the states of the nodes as well. And these three effects are coevolution of states of the nodes and topology of the network, noise, and nonlinearity of interactions. And to analyze this, these three effects and what they can produce, we look as a framework, which is the Wouter model as the simplest starting point, at least in the framework of social technical systems. And I'm sure that I don't have to introduce the Wouter model to anyone at this talk. Nevertheless, I will go through the basic motivation, because I noticed that the social group size of the social group at IFISC decreased slightly over the last 2 years, so maybe it will be useful for someone. So to have a Wouter model, we need two things: a binary state of individuals, plus one and minus one, or green one and red one, and algorithmic definition with state copying, where state copying reflects the real world social influence, a very important mechanism in sociology. And by algorithmic definition, I mean that the model is defined by a set of rules for every time step. So its evolution is defined by this set of rules for every time step. And of course, the toy model is a very simple model, nevertheless, very useful one. And to put our version of this model in the context, I like to present this slide, which I actually saw for the first time at one of the IFISC seminars about 2 years ago, and I really liked it, so I made a copy of it. If we want to describe reality in a phenomenological way, of course, it's not about fundamental laws here. In more realistic way, we have to increase the complexity, include more effects in the model, but then also we lose the analytical and, of course, computational treatability of the model. And to start on this scale, we can have the simplest models, like some simple differential equations. Then we go to some structures, square lattice. These structures can get more complex, some random networks. Then we have coevolving network models after some steps. And this is where are we today in this talk. We have coevolving network model. Then after many more steps, we can get at some adaptive nodes, which have some machine learning algorithm to adapt to the environment for every individual. And after many, many more steps, we can arrive at finally at the Norbert's Wiener cat. As he said, the best material model of a cat is another, or preferably the same cat, which would be very, very realistic, but completely useless, because we want to infer something from the model. We want to simplify the reality to find these basic dependencies. And for this, the Wouter model is definitely useful. And the coevolving one lays somewhere in the middle. And a few applications, because also the model might be known under many different names. In some of these applications, it was named differently, like a Kurman model, for example, and was used to describe species competing over a territory, one of the first applications, but also the physical application of monomer-monomer processes and dimmer-dimmer processes on a square lattice substrate, behavior of ants as well, people selecting a restaurant, stylized facts about stock markets. There was work done on this actually at IFISC. And then opinion dynamics, voting processes, and all these applications in social technical systems, where the question could be, do we actually have an empirical proof that it works there, that it's not only abstract interesting model, but also can be applied? And actually, we do have a proof for this, provided some years ago by Juan, Krzysztof, Jose, Maxi, and Victor. By the way, Krzysztof Suchecki is also from Warsaw, although from a different university. And in this work, they applied the Volter model, fairly simple one, not the simplest, not the standard Volter model. There was a mobility of agents and noise, but effectively a model with only one parameter to fit the data. And they described two stylized facts about US presidential elections. And these facts are vote share distribution and vote share spatial correlation on different scales of coarse graining. So this is quite impressive to fit a model with one parameter to this data. So this is the motivation for using this model. And then, as I said, we want to include three different effects. First of the effects is coevolution of state of the nodes that we have and some pattern of interaction, because usually in the social technical systems it's impossible to for the structure to stay constant in the time scale when the opinion changes. And more importantly, there's a feedback loop between both effects, so we want to include both of them. Then there is a question of possible non-linearity of interactions. And what I mean by that is, let's consider the situation on the right here. So we have the focal node, the active node, with some neighborhood. You can see the laser point, yes?
Yes.
And the question is, in this particular setup, what is the probability that the focal node is going to change its opinion to the opposite one? So it has four neighbors in a different state, three neighbors in the same state. In the standard Volter model, this probability would be just 4/7, because the focal node chooses at random one of the neighbors and copies its opinion, whatever it is. Therefore, it's 4/7 for choosing a neighbor in a different state. But maybe this probability is 4/7 to the power of 2, maybe square root of 4/7. And actually, empirical evidence shows that it can be modeled by a power law, but the power q depends on the context. So for language change, it might be lower than q for opinion dynamic, lower than one, the parameter q. For opinion dynamics, it might be bigger than one. So we include the continuous parameter in the model. And the third element, the noise, is freedom of will, if you wish, or independent decisions of the agents. So the model is non-linear coevolving Volter model with noise. And we have three basic parameters, plasticity p, which is probability of rewiring an edge, non-linearity parameter q, as I described it, and noise rate epsilon. Then in every time step during the evolution of the model, we choose one node, node I, we call it a focal node or the active node, and then we look at this quantity, which is ai over ki to the power of q. Ai is the number of active links of the focal node. So active links are links connecting two nodes in a different state. Therefore, in this setup in the Volter model is just the number, AI is just the number of nodes of neighbors in a different state, divided by the total number of neighbors, so just degree to the power of q. And this is probability that anything will happen. If with this probability something happens, then with probability p, it will be link rewiring. So the focal node I cuts the connection to randomly chosen node j in a different state and creates a new connection to randomly chosen node in the same state, which is important part. And with probability 1 minus p, this interaction will be state copying. So the focal node just changed the state to the opposite one. Then at the end of each time step, regardless of what happened before, we draw a new random state with probability epsilon for the focal node. So if this probability is satisfied, then the focal node has one half chance of being in one and the other state. So this is the basic setup. The question is, what does this produce? And this phase diagram is basically a summary of everything that we obtain in this model. I will now give an overview of this phase diagram, and later I will come back to describe it in detail, but just to keep in mind the basic picture of this phase diagram. So this is a phase diagram of noise rate epsilon against P, probability of rewiring. So this line would be noisy Volter model with no coevolution, no rewiring, and this line would be non-linear coevolving Volter model with no noise. Okay, and it's cut in the middle just to show phenomena on different scales, because showing just one scale we wouldn't see all the phases. And the basic picture is that we have three basic phases, plus two of them can be divided further. So the red and maybe also the different colors of lines correspond to different values of non-linearity parameter. Red is q equal 2, blue is q equal 1, so linear model, and q equal 1 half is the green line. So these phases are, the red area is the consensus phase, phase A, where we have magnetization close to 1 or minus 1, full consensus, one component, and it can be divided further for phase A1 for q equal 1, and A2 for q smaller than for q bigger than 1. For q smaller than 1, the consensus phase doesn't exist at all. Then we have white area, which is the phase B. It is coexistence phase, where we have the same amount of nodes in plus one state and in minus one state and one component in the network. It can be fully mixing B1 or structured B2. I will show what is the difference in a moment. And finally, we have dynamical fragmentation phase, phase C, in which the blue area, in which the network consists of two components in different states, opposite states, on average disconnected, but due to noise and random rewiring, they get connected from time to time, and this is dynamical switching between these two configurations. Then if we increase N, we can see that all the phases except A2, B1, and B2 fade away in the thermodynamic limit. So in the thermodynamic limit, we have only three phases, A2, B1, B2, which means that for Q1 or smaller than 1, it's only two phases, because A2 exists only for super linear case. So this is the general picture. And
excuse me, Tomasz, can you tell me again what's the difference between A1 and A2 phases?
I have slides exactly about this, so maybe I will explain it just in a moment.
Okay.
Because it will be easier if I show the trajectory and magnetization distribution, and I have exactly slides about this just in.
Okay.
If it's okay. But yeah, first we just to understand how these phases look like, we can look at these animations of the stationary state in the consensus phase. In this picture, it doesn't depend if this is phase A1 or A2. In a short animation, we will not see any difference. It's just consensus, most of the nodes in one state, and due to noise, of course, some nodes changing the state and network changing the structure. But on average, just the consensus. Then we have the fully mixing coexistence phase, which is phase B1. Coexistence because we have 50-50 nodes in state minus one and in plus one, fully mixed or well mixed in the main component, and it's one component on average. Of course, there something can sometimes be fragmented, like we can lose single nodes to random rewiring. But this is very different from structured coexistence phase B2, which has also zero magnetization and also one component, but we can see that states of the nodes drive a very clear topological communities. So based on states of the nodes, we can distinguish topological communities as well, which are connected between each other just by a few interlinks. And this is, I think, interesting phenomena, because usually topological communities in the models of community detection are driven by purely topological traits. They are driven by states of the nodes. And then we have dynamical fragmentation phase C, which is on the video might be very similar to the previous one, because in the videos I just omit the time steps where nothing happens. But in this phase, usually we have two separate components and they get connected just sometimes due to random rewiring and noise. But on average, we have two separate components in opposite state. And now the differences between these phases A1, A2, B1, B2. It is the best to look at the trajectories or distributions of order parameters. Here there is a lot of trajectories, but let's focus on phases A1 and A2. So this is a trajectory of magnetization, the red plot, density of active links, the green plot, and largest component size, which is the blue plot. It goes, the scale is hidden here, but it goes from -1, 0 to 1, of course. And in the phase A1 for Q equal 1, this is a, I could say, typical consensus phase where this consensus is not stable. We have, during one realization of the process, the system switches between -1 consensus to 1 consensus and so on and so forth. Of course, there is one component and the density of active links on average is 0. Then for A2, which is for Q bigger than 1, the non-linearity parameter bigger than 1, we have also 0 density of active links, 1 component, but the consensus is stable during one realization. So all the time we stay at the consensus which was realized as the first one. And we can see it also at, in the distribution of magnetization. Here we have, again, A1 for Q equal 1, A2 for Q bigger than 1. And this is sampled over time, not over realizations. So it's one realization of stochastic process. For A1, we have bimodal distribution. For A2, we have unimodal distribution. Of course, both sides are equally possible for every single realization, but if we sample over time in one realization, it's just one single peak. So this is the difference between these two phases. And additionally, only phase A2 persists in the thermodynamic limit, unlike the A1, which disappears. So these are two differences between these phases. Then we have phases B1 and B2. We could see some difference on the video, but looking at the trajectories, magnetization is 0 on average in both examples. Size of the largest component is 1 on average, but density of active links drops significantly. It doesn't look like significant drop here because the scale goes from -1 to 1 here. And the density of active links changes from 0 to 0.5 to 1.5, but it is a significant drop. And however, it is hard to choose a proper value of density of active links to distinguish between these two phases. It's a very arbitrary choice because 0 is, of course, already fragmented phase, but the question could be, is one link connecting to communities enough or 10, etc. So to do this, we we propose a new indicator of this of the phase B2, of the structured coexistence phase, which is overlap between the real communities given by the states of the nodes and topological communities. So here we have the same network, the snapshot of the network from stationary state, with colors on the left indicated the real state of the nodes, green one +1, red one -1, and on the right with colors indicating communities as found by a community detection algorithm, topological communities. And then we look, and then we assign green state for the orange community, red state for the blue community, and we look how well these two communities overlap in the total, in the network divided by the number of nodes. And then we have to also take into account the permutation, because if we have zero overlap, it means that we have perfect overlap if we just permute this assignment. So we have to take maximum over permutations. Therefore, the minimal possible overlap, the worst overlap is 1/2, the best overlap is 1 full overlap. And we can see that in phase B1, fully mixing, we have states more or less well mixed in the network. And overlap with communities is 1/2, so it's completely random assignment of the topological communities. But if we move to the border between phase B1 and B2, we can see more or less that the states of the nodes start to separate from each other, but from the topology we wouldn't say anything just by looking at the network. However, the community detection algorithm already can detect something, and the overlap becomes 0.75 to finally become close to 1 for the phase B2, where we have very clear communities, very well separated states of the nodes, almost perfectly overlapping with topological communities. So we have topological communities driven by states of the nodes. This is the difference between fully mixing and structured coexistence phases. And finally, we have phase C, which looks more or less the same for every value of parameter Q. It's case differently, only for different values of parameter Q. We have zero magnetization on average, the red line, zero density of active links on average, the green line, and the size of the largest component is most of the time, is most of the time 1/2, because we have two components, both of equal size, more or less. And from time to time, we have random rewiring connecting these two components. So the size of the largest component becomes 1 again, and then drops to 1/2. And this dynamical switching, that's why it's a dynamical fragmentation phase. We can also see it on the in the distribution of the largest component size. For most of the phases, like B1, we have just one big component, of course, with some noise. Here is something smaller than one, because due to random rewiring, we can always lose some nodes. But on average, one component. Then at the border with phase C, the network is half of the time connected and half of the time fragmented. And in the phase C, it's mostly fragmented at largest component size equal 1/2. And sometimes it gets connected again. So this is phase C. We also have analytical approximation of the model. I don't want to go into the details of the equation during the online talk, because probably it doesn't make much sense, but I just want to point out that we have some. It's derived from rate equations, accounting for every event that can change either magnetization in the system or density of active links. And as a result, we obtain differential equations, a couple of differential equations for magnetization and density of active links and their change in time. They are fairly difficult to solve, to fully solve, but we can, for example, plot flow diagrams and analyze fixed points, look for fixed points and analyze stability of fixed points. And we can see here fixed points are given by blue dots. The full ones, the full circles, correspond to stable fixed points, and empty circles correspond to unstable fixed points. And we can see, for example, from this flow diagram to this flow diagram, from A to B, the only thing that changes is the value of non-linearity parameter. So we can see that stability of fixed points can be changed by non-linearity of interactions, but the value in magnetization, the value of fixed points cannot. So without noise, we always obtain fixed points at magnetization -1, 0, or 1. Only adding noise, which is done in the panel C, we can not only change the stability of the fixed point, but also we can obtain different values of magnetization in this analytical approximation, of course. And we have also some combinatorial approximation of the phase transition, or just the border between phase C and B2, but this in the paper, maybe I will not go into the details here. So back to the main phase diagram that we saw at the beginning, we have three basic phases, which two of which can be divided further. So we have consensus phase, which doesn't exist at all for Q smaller than 1 for sublinear interactions. For Q equal 1, it's phase A1, which is unstable. The system changes consensus from -1 consensus to +1 consensus, and it disappears in the thermodynamic limit. For Q bigger than 1, it's A2 phase, which not only persists it in much bigger noise, it is also stable at 1 consensus, realized at the beginning of the stochastic process, and it stays there in the thermodynamic limit. Then we have coexistence phase, which can be either fully mixing for bigger noise or structured for smaller noise or bigger probability, rewiring probability. The fully mixing phase V1 is random, which means that the graph is random. We have random graph and random distribution of states of the nodes within this graph. The structured phase B2 is described by emergence of topological communities driven overlapping, perfectly overlapping with states of the nodes. And then we have dynamical fragmentation phase, C, which exists for every value of Q, although scales, it's the smallest, the bigger the Q, the smallest is the region covered by this phase. It disappears in the thermodynamic limit. And it is described by two components, two clusters of opposite state and constant switching between these separate clusters, and one component with these clusters connected just by one or few links. So these are the main results. Thank you for attention. And I will be happy to answer any questions. If there are some. No questions?
Let me, it's not a question, maybe a comment or curiosity. When you show the communities and the states of the nodes, there was a case in which there was a slight difference between the communities and the states, right? Mm-hmm. You can see some cases the communities did not agree with the states.
Yes.
So I just wonder whether there is you use a community detection algorithm. Whether there is a community detection algorithm that takes into account not just the links, but also the states of the nodes.
I haven't heard about the community detection algorithm that would take also into account states of the nodes. And as far as I know, it wouldn't be called a community detection algorithm then, because what community of scientists doing community detection algorithms consider a base truth is exactly states of the nodes. So like the base truth in topological communities is
State of the links.
Sorry?
The state of the links.
Yes, state of the links. No, I think state of the nodes. Like a karate club, for example, the base truth is given from outside the network. It's the main example, which is karate club. This base truth of communities is given by some interactions, but not on the network, some outside interactions between these karate clubs. And then the community detection algorithm tried to find exactly the same topological communities that very well overlap with these interactions out of the network. So like usually these communities are, this base truth is given from something different than the network itself. So I haven't heard about anything including states of the nodes, because like, I know the basic thing is just to say that one community is one state of the node. So then we have a perfect measure and we don't need to look at the topological traits.
One comment to the question by Raul during the seminar on phases A1 and A2. Mm-hmm. Raul, what you did with Tony corresponds for the nonlinear noisy Volter model corresponds to the line P equals zero with no rewiring. So the transition point up there for P equals zero is the phase transition of the nonlinear noisy Volter model.
Okay. What I understand is that for in the phase A1 says here it disappears for large n.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, that's yeah.
Exactly, it's consistent with your results. Not fully. It's qualitatively fully consistent, but the definition of the model is slightly different. I don't remember, but I compared it with Tony, and the definition is slightly different. So the exact values of critical noise, for example, are different as well.
Okay.
Any more questions?
I also have a question.
I have audience here.
Why?
So close this one because it will be.
Okay. Why did the when you showed the videos where the connections were moving and the dots were moving, why did it have any meaning that the whole bunch was moving, or like how are the positions determined?
No. It's just the algorithm for the video. I think it's fully mixing phase. Yes. No, because this is quite hard to plot. Maybe not a single network, but especially to make a video. So the network stays more or less the same at every frame, but changes slightly. Not to otherwise we wouldn't see any movement. Just stratoscope. So this an algorithm which assumes that every node is an electron or something like this. Mm-hmm. And every link is a spring. So okay. They try to go away from each other, but they are kept together by the links. And then if one, I don't know how to fix this in this algorithm, but then if something disconnects from the whole network, it just forces the whole component to collapse more to the border. Mm-hmm. So that's just an algorithm of plotting, but not the result of the model.
Okay.
Any more questions?
Tomasz, I have a question from a say more general perspective. Mm-hmm. There were proposals to detect communities by using that each of the elements is a Kuramoto oscillator. And then looking at different coupling strength, what Kuramoto oscillators are synchronized. That was done by Albert Diaz-Guilera and all these people.
Mm-hmm.
So in that sense, that is imposing an artificial dynamics mm-hmm. to try to detect networks. Mm-hmm. Here you have a network that has dynamics, and then you also, which is a natural dynamics, it's not Kuramoto, it's completely different dynamics, but you observe that the dynamics or what you detect as community by the dynamics is not the community detected by the links. And I don't know if you can, not immediately, but you can think that this might be relevant for commenting on all these attempts to use some artificial dynamics to detect communities.
Yes. Yes, I think it's an interesting point. And also it links to the question of Raul, because actually I haven't heard about this community detection method. And actually it's
Maxi and Raul know that.
Because this I would see as kind of a state of the node, yes? If you put
is adding sort of Kuramoto oscillator with a coupling and then try to see what of those are synchronized or not.
Mm-hmm. Which is kind of looking for topological communities through imposing some states of the nodes and letting them interact.
Some dynamics,
yes. But yeah, I have to look at this because I haven't heard about this work. Actually,
I think that your work here could be interpreted in that context and warning to the people that imposing dynamics try to do that. I mean, at least because this is an intrinsic dynamics that you have in your system. So,
but
what the community detection does and what maybe dynamics.
But the warning is in which direction? Because I didn't understand.
I don't know. That's up to you. You
okay.
Think about that, okay?
I will think, yes.
But sorry, I think that there is a difference with this method of with oscillators, that here there is rewiring of the network.
But I understand, but my question is if in this model that has the intrinsic dynamics and the communities itself, you see these differences, it's to think about what these other models can claim or these other. So I think that is something to be thought about.
Okay, thank you. I will think about it, yes. That's a good comment. Any more comments, questions? If not, then it's already 35 minutes, so I think we can finish, yes?
Okay, thanks very much, Tomek.